If you've been watching my other videos, you already know Oakland, California has become increasingly expensive over the past decade. But what's it cost to live in my neighborhood? Bushrod. So in this cost of living video, I'm gonna cover the same thing I do in all of my cost of living videos. Some of that I can summarize a little bit better because I'm just talking about a neighborhood. But I'll talk about the cost of living and bushrod specific to housing, so rental pricing. I'll review the tax rate for housing in Oakland, the zip code specific healthcare costs, childcare costs, quality of the schools, and whether or not that warrants consideration of private schools, and what those costs are. You can also get down to the specifics of the gas stations you should go to here for gas, the cost of traveling by BART or by bus to the city if you work in the city or other parts of the East Bay.
First off, housing. So Bushrod was one of the most competitive neighborhoods in the national real estate market in 2017. And within Oakland, because of Bushrod's proximity to some of the other attractive neighborhoods like Rockridge, Upper Rockridge, Claremont, Elmwood, and Berkeley, it's still competitive. Over the last 12 months, there's been low inventory just as there has been nationally and within Oakland. So the costs have gone up. In the past 12 months, there were only 44 homes sold, and the median sold price was $1.22 million. The median sold price in the last 6 months was around $1.15 million, and I would attribute that to either there being more fixers on the market or smaller square footage bed bath count homes. If you're moving here and renting, a 3-bedroom, 1.5-bath or above apartment, condo, townhome, or single family home would cost you a median price of $3,900 per month, likely cheaper than some of the cities further in the East Bay like Berkeley and Albany. If you're looking for a smaller unit, 2-bedroom, 1-bath, the median price over the past 6 months was around $2,700 to $2,800 per month. And finally, if you're looking for a 1-bedroom, 1-bath, that'll cost you anywhere from $1,800 to $2,000 per month.
It's actually much cheaper to share, like get a bigger home and share it with roommates than it is, of course, to rent out a 1-bedroom, 1-bath or 2-bedroom, 1-bath.
If you're purchasing a home, another cost to consider is a city transfer tax. Oakland has long had the highest city transfer tax when you buy or sell a property. It's $15 for every $1,000. If you're purchasing, this will be wrapped into your closing costs. If you're selling, that'll be taken from your net profit when you close. This city transfer tax is normally split between the buyer and the seller, 50-50. So if you're purchasing a $1 million property, you'll pay $7,500 additionally in closing costs. Speaking of taxes, for property taxes, the city of Oakland's raised its base property tax rate since 2020. It's now 1.3737% of the assessed value. Prop 13 prevents your base assessment value from going above 2%. There are propositions that often pass that ultimately increase your property tax, and that'll show up on your tax bill as a special assessment with a breakdown of where those additional costs are going. Whether you're renting or buying, utilities are a consideration. So PG&E covers gas and electric. Depending on the size of your property, the amount of energy upgrades, you can expect to spend anywhere from $100 to over $200 per month in the winter. In the summer months, again, not very many of these older homes have air conditionings and the weather's relatively mild, so you can spend anywhere from $40 to $60 per month in the summer months. When I talk about energy upgrades, a lot of these older homes might have lath and plaster without insulation, single pane windows, no insulation in the attic, no solar. The larger homes for a family of four will likely run you an energy bill of $200 or more in the winter months. You have a smaller space or an upgraded condo, you can expect your bill to be a lot cheaper. Waste management is what covers recycling, trash, and compost. You pay $36 per month for a 20-gallon container, and then an additional $11 for your recycling bin, which is also 20 gallons. And then your compost bin, again, 20 gallons will be included in that. If you want additional bins for recycling and compost, recycling bins run about an additional $12 per month. Additional compost bins, $14 per month. Finally, there's East Bay Mud, which covers water and sewer. If you're renting, your landlord will likely pay for this bill as well as the waste management bill. But if you own a home, you're billed bi-monthly. You can expect for a family of four that your water sewage bill would be between $60 and $80. So your bill would be around $120 to $160 per month.
For cable internet, Typically, Xfinity Comcast is the most expensive provider in the Bay Area and in Oakland. For Xfinity Comcast, for basic cable and 400 Mbps internet connection speed, you'll pay about $135 to $140 per month. However, recently a salesperson from Sonic Internet was knocking on doors in Bushrod, offering $200 credit for cancellation with your other internet provider and fiber at 1,000 Mbps connection speeds for only $40 per month with 3 months free. So that's a better deal if you mostly use streaming services like Netflix, Hulu, Amazon Prime, Disney Plus, etc. So Sonic Internet is a more economical option. If you just want to do internet with Xfinity Comcast, 1,000 Mbps connection speed will run you about $100 per month with a router rental.
For transportation, Bushrod is conveniently located in the sense that you are between two BART stations, the Ashby BART or the Rockbridge BART, and one may be more convenient to you depending on what part of Bushrod you live in. Purchasing a Clipper card is cheaper than having a blue ticket, which is the ticket that you get when you go into the BART station each time. If you're commuting to the city from Bushrod, getting from Rockbridge or Ashby BART to downtown San Francisco Civic Center Station will cost you $8.30 with a Clipper card round trip, or $9.30 if you buy the blue tickets. AC Transit has several Transbay lines. The F line runs through Bushrod. If you're commuting using the AC Transit lines and the Transbay buses, better to have a Clipper card or to buy a 31 consecutive day Transbay bus pass for $84.60. That saves you significantly when considering the cost of a single ride to San Francisco. If you are driving, I've talked a couple times about the expense of having a car in California. Registration is very expensive. For a newer car, it can be anywhere from $350 to $400-something per year. And then you don't have to have a smog check. Gas prices in Northern California are expensive. They might not be as expensive as Southern California, but compared to the rest of the United States, they're pretty high. So for premium gas, the cheapest gas station close to Bushrod and Temescal is Arco, where you get premium gas right now in March 2021 for $3.81 per gallon. For the 76, it's slightly more expensive, it's $3.91 per gallon. And for the Chevron nearby, it's the most expensive, it's $4.09 per gallon for premium gas. Other expenses you should think about when having a car: if you don't have a garage or driveway, or you have extra cars that don't fit into your driveway, you don't necessarily need a parking pass. Some parts of Oakland close by Bushrod require parking passes to remain on the street for more than 2 hours at a time. These are more common in neighborhoods that are really close to the BART stations. And those passes cost you anywhere from $75 to $100 per year. So you have to be mindful, even though you don't need parking stickers for most places in Bushrod for residential parking longer than 2 hours on the street, there are street sweeping schedules. So be mindful of those so you're not ticketed. We started ticketing again in 2021 and the cost is no less than $60 per ticket. Good news is a lot of homes in Bushrod have long driveways or garages for car storage. Groceries and eating out. Again, one of the great things about living in Bushrod is its centrality to places that have a lot of other amenities. So Bushrod itself, in terms of grocery stores, has a couple of local grocers and liquor stores and markets. T&K Market is on the corner of Adeline and Shattuck. Even though it's more expensive than a grocery store for household items like cereal, cleaners, toilet paper, eggs, milk, it's definitely cheaper than ordering from Postmates or Uber Eats to get those items. A couple other neighborhood grocery stores include Abion Market and King's Market. And then the chain grocery stores, which are cheaper overall, include Whole Foods, which is technically in Berkeley on Ashby Avenue. And then the two closer ones are Safeway in Rockridge and Trader Joe's in Rockridge. And then for eating out, within Bushrod proper, there are a couple of neighborhood staples. One is Nick's Pizza and Bakery. It used to be just Nick's Pizza. They've expanded and have outdoor space. Their pizzas are comparable to the cost of pizza in other places nearby. There's Nomad Cafe, where you can get breakfast food, coffees. They're open early in the morning. There's Shawat, pardon my pronunciation if I'm not pronouncing that correctly. That's my favorite food, which is Ethiopian, just down the way. And then if you go over the border to Berkeley on Ashby Avenue, there are a ton of other bars and restaurants. Another Ethiopian place, there's Nick's Lounge, which has karaoke. It's mostly a bar. On Telegraph nearby, closer to Upper Temescal, there's A Plus Burger, there's a Thai place, there's Cafe Kaluchi, which also has brunch and is one of my favorite places. There's a neighborhood bar up the way called the White Horse Inn. I believe they still have pool tables. They have comedy shows sometimes, which are really affordable.
And then if you keep going down Telegraph to Temescal, in my neighborhood's video, I talked a little bit about all the bars, restaurants along Telegraph and Shattuck Avenue in Temescal. So those are all easily accessible. And I can display a few menus here so you can get an idea of what the average price for a meal is. And for entertainment, I've already mentioned a few things like Nick's Lounge and the White Horse Inn, but there's also Bushrod Park, which is one of the larger parks in North Oakland. They have tennis courts and a recreational center. The tennis courts, normally it's a lot easier to book there than in other places in Oakland, and it's $10 per hour. The recreational center isn't open yet, but they have an indoor gym. Speaking of gyms, if you consider that entertainment, there are not very many gyms in Bushrod proper. However, there's Game Changer Fitness, which is now open and has unlimited classes for relatively pricey $165 per month. Regarding health insurance, my health insurance is based off my zip code and my age. I'm telling you my age, but you can expect for a non-deductible plan to spend around $511 per month for Kaiser HMO. The zip codes over here are more expensive when it comes to health insurance premiums, unfortunately. Finally, with childcare and schooling, before I talk about childcare, I'll talk about the local elementary schools in Bushrod. In Oakland, there's a lottery system for school placement, so even if you don't live in the neighborhood of the school you desire your kids to go to, there's a chance that you could be placed in that school. You are given preference if you live in the neighborhood of the school you're trying to get your child into. So with Bushrod, there's an advantage because part of Bushrod is Peralta Elementary, which is highly rated on gradeschools.org, is the neighborhood school of part of Bushrod, and Rockridge, of course. Sankofa Academy, which is not as highly rated, also the neighborhood school for the other part of Bushrod. If you decide to send your kid to public school, this could mean saving on private school costs for the elementary years. Unfortunately, in the Bay Area and a lot of the East Bay counties as well, over the last 5 to 6 years, daycare costs and preschool costs have increased 40 to 50%. So I'll give you two examples of some that are local, that are closest to Bushrod, but there are plenty of other resources within Oakland proper. First off, there's Duck's Nest Preschool. Your monthly cost for full-time daycare from 8:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. for a child over 3 years old is around $1,900 per month. And this is for 12 months with a deposit of around $2,500. And if you're considering sending your kid there part-time for 3 to 4 days a week, it's not significantly cheaper. There's also Rockridge Montessori School. In 2021, their rates for full-time, 5 days a week, 7:30 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. for a child that's 3 years or older was $2,577 per month. So that's the cost for living in Bushrod. If you have any questions about moving to the East Bay from San Francisco or from another part of the US, if you're moving to another part of the Bay Area you have questions about, my contact information is below. If you want more videos like this, hit the subscribe button below. And if you have suggestions for videos in the Bay Area, you can comment below.